Chapter 2. How Tom Whitewashed the Fence. The next day was Saturday. The school was shut. All the boys in the village were free. It was a beautiful day. The sun was shining, the birds were singing, trees and flowers looked so fresh and lovely. Tom, of course, wanted to go swimming. All the other boys were going. Tom came sadly out of the house. In one hand, he held a long brush. In the other, he carried a bucket which was full of whitewash. His aunt was making him whitewash the fence. Tom looked sadly at the fence. How high it is, how long it is, he thought. Indeed, the height of the fence was 9 feet and its length was 30 yards. Tom put his brush into the whitewash. He drew it slowly across the fence. It made a very small white mark. Tom tried again, another very small white mark. Tom sat down. He sighed heavily. Then Tom saw Jim. Jim was the boy who helped his aunt with the rougher work at the house. Jim was carrying a bucket. He was going to fetch some water from the village pump. The other boys will be there at the pump, thought Tom. Fetching water is hard work, but it's better than whitewashing. So he called, "Jim, let me fetch the water while you whitewash the fence." "Oh no," replied Jim. "The old lady said that I mustn't help you. She said that you must do the whitewashing yourself." "I'll give you a marble, Jim, if you let me fetch the water." "A marble? Let me see it." Tom held out the marble in his hand. Jim looked at it. He put down his bucket. He took the marble. But Aunt Polly was close behind him. She kicked him hard with her shoe. Jim quickly picked up the bucket and went running down the street. Tom picked up his brush and began working hard. Aunt Polly went back into the house. Tom soon stopped working. He sat down again. He took out all the things that he had in his pockets. He had some marbles, some pieces of string, and 2 or 3 broken toys. "No one will whitewash the fence for these," he thought. "No, I must think of a better plan." He thought and thought. Soon he had an idea. He picked up his brush again. Again he began working hard. Ben Rogers was coming down the street. Tom pretended not to see him. He worked harder than ever. Ben was eating an apple. He looked very happy. He was pretending that he was a big ship and he was rolling like one. He was giving orders in a loud voice and the ship was obeying him. He came up to Tom. He rubbed his eyes. "Why, Tom," he cried in great surprise, "you're working." Tom said nothing. He went on with his whitewashing. He looked very interested in his work. "Tom, you're working," Ben repeated. "Oh, it's you, Ben. I didn't notice you. I'm just going for a swim. You don't want to come, do you? You like working, don't you?" "This isn't work," Tom said quietly. He went on whitewashing.
"Not work?" Ben exclaimed. "Oh no, I like it. Whitewashing is fun. You have never whitewashed a fence, have you?"
"Well, no, I haven't." For a time, Ben stood there watching Tom. Tom paid no attention to him. All his attention was given to his work. At last, Ben said, "Let me whitewash a little."
"Oh no, Ben, I'm going to make this fence look fine. I've promised Aunt Polly. Besides, it's interesting."
"Let me do just a little," begged Ben.
"No, I'm sorry, Ben, but I can't. Aunt said that I must do it myself." If you do it, you will make a mistake. You'll spoil everything. It's looking so nice now. I shan't make a mistake. I'll be careful. You can have my apple if you let me. Slowly and unwillingly, Tom handed the brush to Ben. Ben worked hard. He soon grew hot, but he went on working. Tom sat there watching and eating Ben's apple. When Ben had done enough, other boys came along. At first, they laughed at Tom, as Ben had done. But soon, they were whitewashing the fence. Of course, they had to pay Tom before he let them help him. They gave him their best things. 12 marbles, a tin soldier, a key, a dog's collar, a handle of a knife, and 4 pieces of orange. Tom had a lazy time. He did no work, but soon the fence had 3 coats of whitewash on it. Tom had learned something important that day. He had discovered 2 important laws. The first was, if a man must do something hard, then that is work. If he likes to do something hard, then that is not work. The second law was, if we cannot get something we want badly, if we can get something easily, we do not want it.